Good morning everyone. So here I am making this session to understand how I can share the audio and video through Google Meet. So this is the OBS project software. This is the OBS studio software through which I am recording offline. I am not recording it online, I am recording it offline. Okay. So regarding this OBS studio, I will be discussing more with you guys in the upcoming sessions. So today we will concentrate on how to just share the audio and video with Google Meet. Okay. So from the day when the classes will start, since we are recording the videos in advance, so these can be played for with them other than the live classes as online. So how to play these videos? So if I directly play the video in the Google Meet, so what that we are going to experience is that video is being played or being displayed properly, but audio is not listened. Okay, it is not audible. Audio we can't listen it. Okay, for that reason we have an extension from the Chrome called as a cast, that is a Google Cast, through which I can make audio to be shared with the Google Meet also, other than the video. Okay, so nothing to do, just go to your Chrome browser, see that whether your Chrome browser is synchronized with the account wherein you are going to create the link for the class through Google Meet. So here it is not been synchronized, so I am going to turn on the synchronization with the account through which I am going to create. So I am going to create the Google Meet account using our college domain. So I am going to just get my Chrome browser synchronized with the same account. Okay, now it has been synchronized. Next, I will go to my Gmail to create the link for the Google Meet class. Right. So, as you guys know everything like how to create a Google Meet link and all. So, in the case, just I am going to do it live now. You can just verify it. Okay. So I am going to the calendar app. So this is today, 3rd September. I am going to create the link from 6 to 7, something like that. So I am going to add a title like demo for sharing the audio and video. So here I am going to make the add the Google Meet as the session. So since you are creating the link through your college domain Gmail, so it is allowing you to participate, make 250 participants at a time, and even it will allow you to record also. So you can either even invite the guest, okay, so for whom you are making them to join. Like I am going to make my another email ID as the guest account. So I am going to press save. So it will ask for alternatively to send the invitation through email. I am just clicking yes, send it. So here it is being created. I'm just going to join the Google Meet. So once you are joining in through once you are starting your session, so earlier it will ask for permission to record the attendance. So it is something like you are observing now. Click the account through which you have created the link like now I used it with shrutita.ac.in. Click it. Further, these all things will be made allowed, like record the attendance and create a spreadsheet in the Google Drive so that you can get accessibility, like how many students got attended the class and all. So press allow so that can be done automatically. So I am going to keep the mic mute, or else if it is on, it is okay. Then I am going to join the session. Now what I am going to do, I am going to join the session alternatively through the Gmail account to whom I sent the invitation for. Okay. So I joined the session. I joined the session with my another account, okay. Right. So how the attendance is recorded? It is in different way. Here you can see the attendance is recorded as according to the participants are available. Okay. So now only one participant is available. That is my another Gmail account. You can log in through some other more Gmail account. Let us see how to send the a link to your students. Nothing to do. For that I am going to share my mobile screen. Just please observe it. So this is my mobile screen that I am sharing. Just go to the Gmail where you got the invitation. So usually the invitation will be in this form once you add up as a guest. So nothing to do is just copy the URL, go to the series of groups wherein you want to send this invitation, like third year B section I want to add up. So okay, so like second year D section. So here I am going to paste the link, and you can further add up some details like class starts at something like 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. on 3rd September 2020, and you can just send the link, okay, like this. So since I don't want to do this, I'm just going to delete it. Okay, right. I'm going to stop the session sharing the screen now because my work is done. Okay, right. Now let me show you how the differentiation will be there, like if you present the screen normally as according to the normal way, like presenting the screen through your Google Meet, as well as using some extra other extensions that will help you to cast or share the video and audio. So if I go for presenting screen through normal way, so my screen is getting presented through the Google Meet. So whatever I do now, I will go for any PPT's presentation, I can go for it, or else I can do play the audio or video. But the thing is that if we go for a normal way of presenting this in the Google Meet, then if I do play audio, video or audio online, either through using YouTube or any of the downloaded videos in our storage device, so video will be visible, but audio will not be getting heard properly. So if you want to experience, let me go for recording the session so that you will come to know once recorded whether audio is being heard or not. As because I am recording this offline through OBS Studio software, so you may be hearing the audio, but once you see or check out the recording through the Google Meet, then you can experience that audio was not heard with the participants, only the video was visible. Okay, so here is a record meeting button available if you log in with your college domain Gmail. Okay, so I will just click it to record my meeting. So it will ask for a permission, to press accept. So here you can see at the left hand side upper corner, the recording is getting started. So it depends on the internet speed. Like internet is very fast, so you will get it very quickly. So right, let me go for a YouTube now. And I'm going to play some random YouTube video. So to experience about how the audio and video are being shared. Now I am sharing the audio and video through a normal way. I am not using any extension. Let me play this first video regarding how to make Google Meet effective with 5 Chrome extensions. Since I'm experiencing little bit low bandwidth with my internet, so it is taking a little bit more time to just play the things online. But let me wait for it, as it is the main agenda that we need to understand.
Hey friends, welcome to another episode. My name is John Sowash, and in this video, you're going to learn about 5 Chrome extensions that will make your Google Meet experience even better. Now, Google Meet and Zoom and other video conferencing tools have become a central focal point in the classrooms of teachers around the world due to the coronavirus school shutdown. The question of Meet versus Zoom comes up all the time. I probably answer that question 1 to 3 times every day, but honestly,
so this was regarding at the online. So suppose if I want to play anything offline, like any of the video what is downloaded or created by me, let me go to that offline video. Like I am having an offline video like web technology demo too. So let me play it. So let me go at some middle of the session so that I can experience the
text is a text displayed on a computer
so here,
display or any other electronic
clearly
devices
I can hear the audio
other text that the
and that will be recorded through your OBS software.
So hypertext documents are interconnected by
Google
hyperlinks
Meet, your participants
which
are unable to hear the audio
with a mouse click
okay.
Or
with the Google Meet
or
your participants
screen.
Are not able
so
to hear
the audio.
I will
be telling you about this hypertext mode.
So what I will
Let
do, I will immediately
next,
pause this
word that is pre.
So how can I make your participants to hear the audio? Video is available very quite easily, but your participants are unable to hear the audio. So how to do that? So very simple, just go back to your Chrome. So go back to the 3 dots what available, go to the cast. Once you click on the cast, you will get the icon like this. So you can see like always show icon, so it will be visible every time. The thing what I did at the earlier to synchronize is, if I do synchronize, then I will get the services like enable cloud services. So these cloud services will help me to share the screen online or offline so that the participants can hear audio also with the respective video what you are trying to play in the Google Meet especially. Okay, so for a better reason, let me reset it. Okay, right. So now what I will do, I will stop presenting the screen in the normal things, in the normal way. I stopped presenting the screen. Now what I will do, I will go for the tab what I want to cast or what I want to present. Then I will go to the Google Cast. Now it is showing no devices are available. Let me reset it again. So this usually happens because to get the permissions from the organization, it will be delayed. Or it may also depend on the internet speed of your right. Now demo Google Meet is available, so I will click on this. So this will cast my tab. So it is now kind of showing connecting. Let us wait for some more couple of minutes. As because I am experiencing very much low internet connectivity, so it is taking a huge amount of time or more time to connect. So now I am going for the another way of sharing the screen or casting the screen online and offline using Google Cast. It is taking too much of time. Let it get connected. Parallelly, we can understand what are these options. So, cast tab will help me to share the online content, cast tab, with the audio as well as the video. Cast file will help me to share the offline content, what is being saved in our desktop, And there is another option called as the cast desktop. So better not to go with that option. For online use cast tab, for offline use cast file. It took too much of time. Let me reconnect. Oh, showing no devices are available. Let me resynchronize or reset the cast. Yeah, this is all due to the internet connectivity. So since my connection is very low, I'm feeling some inconvenience to connect to the device. Right, the device is available, so I'm going to just click it on. So it is casting, so you can get the screen presented online through the Google Cast. You can see the tab what I was displaying with the YouTube. So now if I play, you will be able to hear. So the sources what I'm using is cast tab. It will help me to share the online content. So if I play this, you can be able to hear the audio also. Experiencing is due to low internet connectivity.
Even better.
But I hope you are listening to some clips of some
Zoom and other video conferencing tools have become a
It is purely due to the internet connectivity, where internet connectivity is too low at my place. So because due to which the online content, the YouTube is not being played so properly as it was required. So let me go for some settings so that I can set for low configuration of the video and I can get the audio very quickly. So that I just lowered the configuration of the video. So let me play it. If suppose I'm going to get the audio properly.
Point in the classrooms of teachers around the world due to the coronavirus.
So again, there is a lot of different disturbance. Streaming problem, it is due to internet connectivity. So I hope you are able to hear the sound. So other than the online content, if I want to share the offline content, just go for the resources. Like first stop the sharing the screen, so it removed the particular, then go for resources, cast file from the offline. So it will pop up another window wherein you can choose the content with what you want to play. So I will go to downloads, I will check out for another offline video what is available with me. Like I am having some video here, so I will open it. So here it is showing me, like click this, so it will cast you the offline video. So I hope it is being visible on the screen. Offline.
Good morning and welcome to this session. So here with I am going to
recast it, as because it was not been successfully updated previously. So I'm going to downloads, I'm going to the video, open, then here it is available. I'm going to click it. The screen is presented from the offline video, so I will just play it up. Hope you are getting the audio. So again there is a disturbance because my internet connectivity is too low to connect to the offline or online content, but I hope you can see that the audio is listened properly. So due to the low internet connectivity at my place, you are experiencing in this way. Not a matter. So this can be resolved with the good internet connectivity. That is okay. But my aim was to tell how actually the online content or offline content, audio and video, both can be shared using some Chrome extension, that is Google Cast. Okay, right. I'm going to stop this. I'm going to stop this again. Right. Better let me try it again. So I'm going to cast the file offline. It will again pop me up some menu. So I will go for some file. Looking at the web technology demo. So once I load it, I need to click it here, so that will be loaded at the Google Meet. So that will be loaded at the Google Meet. Okay. I hope the screen is available. just fast forward it. Okay, here you can't be able to hear the audio, as because it is not the file what I need to play. Let me go for the alternative one. Like to downloads. Okay, right.
Good morning and welcome to this session. So
why I am going for multiple times is just to get the in proper audio and video. Hi guys, good morning once again. So this is the second video that will help us to check out what was there available with the Google recording. Okay, so for that let me go back to your Chrome. I will go to my Gmail account where the recording is stored. So you can see the recording is made available. So either you can go directly in this way, or you can go for your Google Drive with the respective account. You can see now there is an option here, button available. Click it, it will go for the next down another option like Meet Recordings. Click Meet Recordings, it will take you to the place where your recordings are stored. Okay, so these are various recordings that are being done earlier. So today's recording. It will be saved with the timing and all. So here is the session of mine with Sultana Madam. Just I'm going to play it. So sometimes what happened, it may, it will be automatically shifted to my Chrome browser. Okay. This browser tab, it will be shifted. So if I play this, you will be able to hear the sound. Are you able to hear the sound?
My undergraduation and post-graduation from
Bus. Now you are able to hear the sound?
Yes, sir.
So this is with the any online videos, if you want to play through YouTube, then it is for the YouTube one. So other than that option, I think now you can see it is white. It is quite blue color in it is showing, right? So it is what? It means what? It is active sharing now.
Where's
my browser? It is showing blue color now, madam. Earlier it was white color. Like browser. if I stop sharing,
sir, white.
Once I share this, it will become this color, blue color.
Yes, sir.
Right. It means what? It is started. So I am stopping this one. I will just resume my screen there. Right. So what I can do, this is one way to share the tab videos. Okay, madam?
Okay, sir.
So from your YouTube. So source is like cast tab.
Okay.
Now if you want to cast any file, you can go for a file selection. It will be what? It will be showing up your another window to open the file from your computer system. From your computer system.
Okay.
So I have some couple of videos here with my computer system. Just I will open it up. So now here this will cast your desktop.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So this is from the desktop.
Okay, sir.
It is not from the online tab.
Good morning and welcome to this session. So
can you hear the voice?
I'm going to explain
about
web technology.
Right.
So before starting with the course, let us
like this is what the Chromecast, which will help us to share the audio as well as video. Once first with your YouTube online, like cast tab button, and another one is cast file.
Yes, sir.
But you are unable to hear the sound.
Yes, sir.
But you are. So now I am going to rewind it backside, wherein I am just telling madam that once I go with a normal type of sharing the screen to Google Meet, whether I am getting the audio or not. Just I am going to play it up. If I will open one YouTube. I had that extension earlier. Rejoin, that is not a problem. Okay, madam? Students will rejoin the meeting, not a problem. They will rejoin. Option called as meet attendance. I think it got I will just play one random video.
Okay, sir.
Are you able to hear the sound, madam?
No, sir.
No, na?
No, sir.
But I am playing the video.
Yes, sir.
But you are unable to hear the sound.
Yes, sir.
But you are unable to hear the sound. That is what, na?
Yes, sir.
Right. So now it is one of my demo video regarding web technology. So I am just playing it. I think you are unable to hear the sound. Okay.
No. Yes.
So this is what the application Chromecast will do. What we have to do, once we get synchronized, we have to start up with the enable cloud services. So it will enable all the services such as sharing the audio and video. Okay. So once we get here, you can see it will show castyoutube.com.
Yeah. Okay.
So till now it is showing no devices found. Why? Because I am opening this from my another account wherein my synchronization is with different account. Just what I will do, I will copy this. One second, madam.
Okay.
Copy link address. Okay.
Yes.
So we'll go to my previous account. So what I will do anyhow, I stopped this one. Not required. So what I will do, just paste it here. So I will be able to open my that video. Right. I hope now also you will be not able to hear the sound. Are you able to hear the sound, madam?
No, sir. No sound.
Okay, right. So what I will do, I will just go for enabling the cloud services.
Mm-hmm.
So once I did, you can see there is a Google Meet demo source.
Yes.
That is source available. If I click this, I will cast a tab. Source not supported, it is telling. I don't know why. Right, it's available now. So
yes,
if
sir.
I do cast it, what it will do, the thing what we are sharing earlier, my screen.
Yes, sir.
In this, it will be automatically shifted to my Chrome browser. Okay.
Uh-huh.
This browser tab, it will be shifted. So if I play this, you will be able to hear the sound.
Mm-hmm.
Are you able to hear the sound?
My undergraduation and post-graduation,
yes,
from
now you are able to hear the sound?
Yes, sir.
So this is with the any online videos, if you want to play through YouTube, then it is for the YouTube one. So
okay.
Other than that option, I think now you can see it is white. It is quite blue color in it is showing, right? So it is what? It means what? It is active sharing now.
Yes, sir.
Right, guys, so this was one of the sample video wherein we understood, like, if we use that Google Cast, then it will allow us to record both the audio as well as video, or else to share the audio as well as video. So if we don't use that, then audio will not be heard, only video will be a video can be visualized. Okay, right. So this is the end of the part 2, that is session number 2. So right, I am going to share both the links in the group. Please go through it and understand how to use the Google Cast for sharing the audio and video. Thank you guys, bye bye.